the morning star, drive on 17.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the morning star, drive, you know.
Hey everyone, how's it going? It is Monday, November 16th, and this is the Morning Star Drive on 117.8. We're on YouTube, so make sure to subscribe, follow us on SoundCloud, and support us on Patreon. Now today we'll get some coronavirus updates. Hong Kong pro-democracy lawmakers resigned together in protest, terrorism in Saudi Arabia, the fight against the Islamic State, and some more US news we missed over the weekend. And of course, more than anything else, we have the Sunday sermon, the message about the Lord is the path of eternal life. So everyone, how was your week? I'm sure you guys were able to enjoy your weekend and just really rest, get some total relaxation, receive grace from the Sunday message. And this week's message was just awesome. And now it's Monday again, and we can restart another amazing week with the Lord. Now, this is the week of really loving the Lord and knowing clearly about the Messiah, the path of life. So let's do this together on the Morning Star Drive. Thanks for joining us here today. Like and comment below. We want to hear how you guys are doing. Make your requests, your questions, or what you guys are thinking about these segments. Taco Tuesday, Bubble Talk last week, talked about the story of Daniel and dealing with difficult people. So go ahead, check out those two videos out on our Especialist Guy YouTube channel. Please pray that our channel can grow more and more and reach the next level. Oh, and just for you guys to know, we have finally hit monetization on our YouTube site. So that is a great sign. It's 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of watch time in 12 months. So we were able to do that quickly in 6 months. So I'm really thankful for all of you joining us and just supporting us. Definitely encourage you to check out the live Taco Tuesdays and Bubble Talks every Tuesday, Thursday, 8 p.m. Malaysia time, live streaming on both YouTube and Facebook. Yesterday was the Sunday edition, and we interviewed Christine Ocampo from Singapore, who's currently the female campus leader in her church. Inspiring, fun interview. Make sure you catch the Sunday edition this week. Now, big shout outs to Mari and Nelly in Australia, and also Christine in LA for believing and supporting this channel on Patreon. Now, if you want to support us too, then check out the Patreon link in the description. And if you're on SoundCloud, click the blue button on the homepage. Patreon is a crowdfunding site that you can support the Morning Star Drive at just $3 a month. So at the moment, we have lecture training videos on the site and the Monday Bible studies I do on Zoom. They will be there every week. All right. And of course, tonight is the Monday Open Bible Studies. It is a sixth lecture, and I'm still thinking about which one I should do. We have over 50 newcomers, which is great, and super excited about this, and it'll be posted only on Patreon. All right, so let's move on to the featured artist of the day. Featured artist today on this cool, interesting, fun Monday is Kuma Chang from Japan. We're going to hear the song Second Hero, or it's Hero Second. I'm not sure which one it is, but that's from Kuma Chang over there in Japan. Second song from Dire Wings in Korea, and this song is called Do Not Block This Way. In Korean, it's like Wemaga, right? Wemaga, which means why do you block? And it used to be an old song, but they completely redid it into this amazing, awesome pop song. Third song, last but not least, J-Root from the Paper Music Associates in Korea. This song is Reflecturing featuring J-Yo. So more than anything else, guys, we need to support our member artists from around the world and make sure you give them a prayer or a shout out each and every day during the pre-dawn.
We just gonna crank it up, crank it up. We just gonna crank it up, crank it up. Yeah, 時は2078この場所から作り上げる価値。今日も先生中運命いつか毎瞬間自分の考え しないでブレイクスルー目立ったとこだけカッコつけんなら抜け出せないのさ Thank you、舞台は生活気取りの時こそ進化する普段の開発行う分だけ変化するまずはかつて自分になすべないなら生み出せ一発で今の僕にまだ何にもない上等明日もが何
でトライ 매일 쳐다보는 reflection. Faking it, faking it, faking it. Cracking the mirror, just crack me up. Yeah, yeah, I'm faking it, faking it. Faking the mirror, just say it. 도망가지, 도망가지만 도망가죠, make you go around. 이제 내가 판단을 해. 이제 내가 날 걸로 해. 쳐다보지 말라고 여간을 regret it. 아무리 말해봐도 너의 머릿속에 다시 내게 물어봐. Now you know, no, no, no. Just keep going, everything what you do. 지워내면 선명해져 in your face. 두 눈을 감아봤자 you're naked. 절대 돌아볼 수가 없다는 게 I fall into the trap, yeah. 매일 쳐다보는 reflection. I'm faking it, faking it, faking it. Cracking the mirror, just crack me up. Yeah, yeah, I'm faking it, faking it. Faking the mirror, just say it. 도망가지, 도망가지만 도망가지, make you go around. 이제 내가 판단을 해. 이제 내가 날 걸로 해.
뒤바뀌었지 아닌 건지 everything real I got on go. You know
지워내면 선명해져 in your face. 그 눈을 감아봤자 you're naked. 절대 돌아볼 수가 없다는 게 I fall into the trap, yeah.
매일 쳐다보는 reflection. Faking it, faking it, faking it. Cracking the mirror, just crank me up. Yeah, yeah. Faking it, faking it, faking it. Faking the mirror, just say yeah.
도망가지, 도망가지만 도망가죠, make you go around. 이제 내가 판단을 해. 이제 내가 나인 걸로 해.
불안한 나를 더 미워해줘. Oh, oh, oh. 불안한 나를 더 위로해줘. Oh, oh, oh.
매일 쳐다보는 reflection. I'm faking it, faking it, faking it. Cracking the mirror, just crack me up.
Yeah, yeah. Faking it, faking it, faking it. Faking the mirror, just say yeah.
도망가지, 도망가지만 도망가죠, make you go around. 이제 내가 판단을 해. 이제 내가 날 걸로 해.
And that was J-Root from the Paper Music Associates in Korea. That song was Reflection featuring J-Yo. Hope you guys enjoyed that song. Before that, Dio Wings from Korea, Do Not Block This Way. Of course, the featured artist of the day is Kuma Chung all the way over there in Japan. That song was Hero Second or Second Hero. You know, I'm going to have to ask him which one this is. I actually really, really want to meet Kuma Chung. And also the other guy from the sky. What's his name? Is Maki? I really want to meet those guys, so hopefully someone can get me an introduction to them. Which means it brings us into a time of the coronavirus updates for the entire weekend. So a lot of the stats just going to be going through the roof, and of course we know that it's going nuts in Europe and America right now. So let's just take a look. In the world, we're already up to 54.3 million cases, 1.3 million deaths. But good news once again is the mortality rate has dropped down to 2.43%. The US, 11.2 million cases, 251,000 deaths at 2.24%. India, 8.8 million cases, 129,000 deaths at 1.47%. Brazil, 5.8 million cases, 167,000 deaths at 2.83%. France at 1.9 million cases, 44,000 deaths at 2.26%. The UK, 1.3 million cases, 51,000 deaths at 3.85%. To round up the top six, Italy with 1.1 million cases, 44,000 deaths at 3.9%. Yes, every single country in the top six have over 1 million cases. Now, some of you guys wondering why these countries keep changing every day. I go strictly by the daily infection rates. So there are top six countries that have the most daily infection rates, and I use that as my barometer of which countries to report on. Okay, so let's take a look at Sweden. I report on Sweden mainly because they were the one country that didn't go into full lockdown, and they are down to 3.48%, which is great news. It's a big drop. I think it went dropped by 0.2%. Belgium, unfortunately, once again goes up again, and they're now at 2.69%, which is a 0.02% increase. Now let's take a look at the daily infection rates for the day. The US, well, on Friday, guys, it was like 185,000 cases in a day. Good thing yesterday it dropped to 157,000 cases and a 1% increase. But they had like 4 or 5 days straight of new records for daily cases, okay? India, 41,000 cases. Italy at 37,000 cases, a 3% increase. France at 32,000 cases, 2% increase. And we have the UK. Okay, the UK came in at 26,000 cases at 2%. Now, let's take a look at the Southeast Asian countries. Indonesia has made this huge jump. They're up to 5,200 cases in a single day. I think that could be a record for them. The Philippines down to 1,600, and Malaysia goes back up to 1,114 cases in a given day. I really thought it was going down, but it did not. So it's kind of crazy. Okay, so we're gonna take a look at a couple things that are happening over the weekend. Of course, I don't want to just talk only about what happened in what's happening in America, but I also want to talk about different things that are happening around the world. Okay, so let's start first with Hong Kong. Now, what's happening in Hong Kong is like all the pro-democracy lawmakers or people in the legislative branch, you know, the people who make the law, they have resigned in protest. Now, what happened is 4 MPs were expelled already from the House, I guess you'd call it, right? And these MPs were expelled. Why? Because the government just passed legislature, right, that allows Carrie Lam, which is the prime minister of Hong Kong, she is able to expel legislators without having to go through courts. So this is something that's kind of quite ridiculous if you think about it, guys. There's no courts. This president or this prime minister can just say, I don't like you, you're out. So basically they're saying that these people, anyone who endangers national security will be kicked out. And basically through China and Carrie Lam, who is the leader at this moment, they are trying to stamp down opposition voices. And China came in, or actually the people were basically supporting this and saying it was necessary. It was a necessary measure to make this law to maintain rule of law in Hong Kong and constitutional order of special autonomous region, right? So they said it was rational and reasonable, which is quite crazy. I was watching an interview with one of the MPs that was actually kicked out, one of the four, and basically he was called out for quote unquote endangering national security. So I really, really hope things start changing over there, and maybe the U.S. and some other countries start coming in and because China is causing all these problems. I'm not sure why we're so focused on other countries. Like, yeah, it's pretty crazy. So I hope that we can pray for that situation too. Also in Saudi Arabia, it's pretty interesting also. There were 2 terrorist attacks in 3 days, okay? And the Islamic extremists, they took responsibility for it. Okay, so what's happening is it is an attack against Saudi Arabia, where the crown prince has vowed to smash Islamic State with an iron fist. And also France, you know what happened in France with the Charlie Hebdo cartoons about the Prophet Muhammad and all that stuff, crazy stuff going on in France with the beheadings and stuff like that too. So there's 2 attacks that happened last week. The first of which was a bomb. The first of which, the second one was the ceremony. There was a ceremony. Both of them had to do with a ceremony commemorating the end of World War I. Okay? So they were having a ceremony at a cemetery in Saudi Arabia, and present were diplomats of France and the US and Saudi Arabia, and someone took a bomb, threw it over the wall, it detonated, right? And basically, you know, it just caused all havoc. No one died, thank God, but you know, think about that. All these diplomats are there in a ceremony to commemorate World War I. And because France diplomat and Saudi Arabia diplomat were there, Islamic extremists threw a bomb over the fence where they're having this meeting. And they said all chaos broke loose. The first attack was also The second attack, actually, oh, that was the first attack, the ceremony, right? The second attack was a terrorist opening fire on an embassy, which is quite crazy. And of course, once again, it was another, because it was a day to commemorate World War I. So this is all on Wednesday. Someone opened fire and shot 20 bullets towards the embassy. Obviously, the Islamic State took responsibility. They're doing this to go against Saudi Arabia and France, who are kind of, I guess in their eyes, it's going to be a holy war coming against the nation of Islam. So they're striking first, I guess. So Saudi Arabia prince, the crown prince, has vowed to strike at ISIS with an iron fist and will continue to confront all extremist behavior. And Macron, the president of France, also is saying the exact same thing. And if you look at all around the EU, they are having this kind of war with the Islamic State. Like, even if you look at Austria has these, like, pretty strong proposals against Islamic State. Like, they want to ban all political Islam. Like, so anyone from Islam trying to be in politics, trying to bring an agenda Islamic politics, they want to ban all that. They want to jail terrorists for life. These are some of the proposals. Electronic surveillance for those convicted, right, with digital bracelets, criminalizing political Islam extremism, and all terrorism or Islamic, these extremist offenses. They want to criminalize all of it, and also they're even talking about shutting down mosques, which is crazy too, because that's what they say, where they build these extremists, the education goes on to build these types of extremists. So this is quite scary to see that these things are going on too. One thing I will do is I'll just give a quick update, something that's not the election. I will talk about election just for a second, but before that, Trump just signed a new executive order again, protecting U.S. investors from unintentionally funding the Chinese military. Okay, so the Chinese military, the developing Chinese military getting advanced weapons, weapons of mass destruction is increasing, and it's a very big threat to the U.S., whether it's home or abroad. So the strategy that China uses is they compel or force private sector companies in China to support the military. And so what's going to happen from starting January 11th next year, any transaction of U.S. companies and Chinese military companies will be outlawed. So that company will be outlawed, just to make sure that no one is dealing with any companies that will support the Chinese military, which is quite crazy. Two things that happened that we might have missed over the weekend, which is good news to know. Well, it's just good news to know about the election is there was one of the lawsuits that Trump brought up was upheld, or not. They won one and they lost one. Okay, so the one they won was in Pennsylvania, and the judges ruled in favor of Trump. Basically, the Secretary of State for the state of Pennsylvania changed the election deadline when she has no authority to do this. So any ballots that were being validated after November 9th is no longer valid. It can still be appealed and contested, but from this ruling, anything after November 9th, so anyone coming to validate their vote from November 10th to the 12th, they will no longer be valid. Okay, so there's the one that they won. It's not many votes either. The second one was in Michigan. The Michigan judges ruled against Trump for vote. You know, when he basically asked for injunctive relief to stop, stop. I believe it's certifying the vote and doing a recount or an audit, right? And it was dismissed, or it wasn't really lost. It was basically dismissed because the injunctive relief is only like a last resort if there are no other options. And at the moment, there are still other options that they can take into before an injunctive relief, right? So it's dismissed because besides the recount and the audit in Michigan is actually starting. So there's no need to kind of go into this. And that's why the judge kind of dismissed it and said, hey, it's not closed. Like, the case is not closed. Why? Because it's possible you might need an injunctive relief in the future, but at this moment, it's not going to be honored. Okay? So that's what's going on in the voting. Sunseem did talk about the authority being passed on to Biden already. And I'm hoping that he's getting good. This is either real time from God saying like, this is done, it's done. Or it could be someone reporting to him saying, oh, it's already been transferred over. right? So who knows? Like, we'll see what happens at the very, very end, because in the end, we're going to know, right? In the end, we're going to know. So let's just wait till the end and see what happens, okay? So that is the current news for today. Hope you guys really got a good idea of what's happening over the weekend, or what happened from last week, which means we're going to go into a time of, what do you call it? We're going to go into a time of praise and worship, okay? So we're going to start off with something that we're all looking forward to, and I do believe that many people in this world are all getting it wrong, because one thing that Sun seemed to talk about in the past is looking for the ideal world. You will never get it from politics. Politicians will never give the ideal world, and that's why you can't really hope in them that much, right? The only hope we have is God. So our first song we're going to sing is The Ideal World 2, okay? And then how do we remedy and build the ideal world? We have to preach the words of life. So we're going to sing, Let's Preach the Word of Life. And then, of course, last but not least, a song we can all just get deeply into is Life of an Apostle, because that's the life that we have to live. So I hope that all of us here together will live the life of an apostle, giving glory to the Holy Trinity.
Thank you. This time let us arise. Rise up, shine your light. Release a new word of life to every soul in the world. Truth is on fire, so you're blazing. Giving all our youth, giving all our youth. We are raptured perfectly only through love. We attain heaven called the city.
will see heaven on earth. We'll fulfill all God's wishes and dreams. Oh, heavenly love, how can it be? Trinity above, I'm going to live as an apostle, protecting the Lord till the end of my days. I'll live for you with all my heart, and I will testify with all my life. This is my time, apostle, shine your light.
That is that wonderful song, Life of an Apostle. I believe it was written by one of the Revelation receivers in Japan a while ago. Before that was Let's Preach the Word of Life, and of course, the Ideal World 2. And I really believe that we have to be even more strongly clinging towards God, because the ideal world will never be made by politics. It'll never be made by the former faith, but only by the Lord of this time period. Amen. All right, so now that we're getting a little bit deeper into the podcast, we're going to get into a special section, of course. It is the Word Study. And just amazing, 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 amazing message on Sunday. And it makes people think a lot more deeply, but I think we have to think much more clearly about what the Lord is saying at this time. And I can really feel, it almost feels like there's a different Shimjung in the way that Sun Tzu is preaching right now. It's much maybe it's just me, but I feel like there's more urgency, you know, something different, like something's going to happen, something's going to change. So I really hope that all of us here too can really take on the Lord's Shimjung, understand exactly what's happening on at this time. So a couple things I want to talk about from this message, I like it when, even when Sun Tzu speaks before, like during the conducting time. And, you know, of course, it talks about like, oh, you know, God only acknowledges it when you actually get something done and makes sense. But then his interesting part here, he talks about, when does God acknowledge your love? And that is something that is really, really, I think it's a question a lot of people think about. And it's true, because the way that it was put in that introduction to the song Path of Love was like, man, God's love is like quintillion times greater than our love. The amount of love he has for us is so grand and great, it is beyond measure, that you couldn't even compare our love to the love of God, right? You can't even compare it. But then the question was, when does God acknowledge your love, right? Even though, can you imagine that if you were someone that made quadrillion dollars, like quads of dollars, just so much money, it's just coming out, you know, you just stink like money, okay? And then someone made $10 in an hour. Like, how would that excite you or make you feel like, oh my goodness, you made $10 an hour, when you're making like $10 million an hour, right? And it was really, really interesting. And the answer was, it was such a simple statement, is if you really do your best to love God, God will acknowledge it. If you do your best. And that made me think, and I think it's something we have to think about, because I know that a lot of people will always think to themselves, oh, but I could have done better. Is that really my best? Will really God acknowledge my love? Why? Because I've loved more than this before. It's true, isn't it? Sometimes when like you get acknowledged by Sun Tzu, or you know, sometimes you look at it and you're like, man, like I think you picked the wrong time to give me a compliment, because this is a time where I'm struggling and this is a time where it's so hard for me. Haven't you guys ever had that before? Like someone is praising you, or, you know, God is praising you, whatever it is. And you're thinking to yourself, like, no way. Like, you could have praised me a month ago and I would have accepted it because I was doing well back then. But right now, I'm not doing well. And I really thought about it. I was like, yeah, it's true. Because what does it mean to really do your best to love God? And it actually makes a lot more sense that you are acknowledged in the difficult times. And you're like, what? That doesn't make sense, because I'm not doing my best. And the answer is I think doing your best in our minds, it actually means to do, like, to be at the peak. the peak of how much I get done, the peak of how I feel, the peak of everything else. It's really weird because when you look at the word best, you're thinking about really, really, really amazingly good. But when I think about it even more deeply, what does it mean to do your best, right? Like the amount of effort that's put in when you're doing really well is much less than when you're struggling and you're just scraping through. The amount of energy and love that's needed for that, I thought, yeah, actually that's more, right? Doing your best, I'm not sure if that literally means that you're at peak performance. Because I, like, you know, for me is, I watched, those of you guys know Michael Jordan. Like, I grew up with Michael Jordan, and there's a movie, there's a documentary called The Last Dance. I think it's 10 episodes. And there's one thing, one of the games that he played in called the flu game, and he had a flu and scored like 38 points, and just, and that one was praised as even better because he had a flu and he still went out and did an amazing job. And I think that we have to kind of rethink what it means to be our best. I don't think, I really don't believe it means that we have to be at peak performance. Like, we evangelized 25 people this year, and then we did this, and we never missed a pre-dawn, and we did that. No, I don't think that's going to be your best. Or else God would never acknowledge us. And if you think about it, even with a child, if you have your own child that you love to death, like you would die for this child, man, even though you're making like $80,000 a year, and if this kid works really hard and makes like 10 cents, you know how happy you'd be when you see this kid so happy to earn 10 cents? It's crazy when you think about it, right? And I think we really do need to think about what does it mean to do our best to love God. And I do think it's much harder, and we're doing better, like as an effort and putting in effort to do, just to stay in that same position when we're struggling and stuff. So I hope that kind of changes our hearts and our minds. Another one that was really good is when Pastor Joan talked in the intro, because her intros are just amazing, right? Is how to unite with the Lord. And everyone talks about this, but it was explained so well. I'm like, yeah, that makes sense now. Like, you know, when someone says, if you want to like unite with the Lord, like you totally have to just like listen to the word, right? But the way she explained it was so simple and so easy. I'm like, okay, that makes sense. So what basically, it's like, how do you unite with the Lord, right? So it's like, first you take action on the word the Lord preaches, okay? So whatever Sunseem said this week, he said yesterday, you got to do it. And then you are participating with him, right? So you're like, oh, that makes sense. I am participating with the Lord, which is great. I'm doing things together with the Lord, okay? When I put the word into action. So first thing is that we're already answering the question, how do I do it together with the Lord if I do what the Lord says, okay? Now, the reason that's even better when it came throughout the message is, the message does not come until the Lord does it, right? So you got to think about this, guys. The Lord does it first and then gives it to us. So he's already done it and then gives us the word, which means that if we put the words into action, what happens? We are doing the same act. We're doing the same actions of the Lord because he did it first, taught us, and now we're doing the exact same thing as him. What does that mean? We've literally become the body of the Lord. Because he actually did it already. And now we're doing the exact same thing he does if we put the words into action, and then we become united with him. We become the Lord's body, right? And I was like, oh, that is the most simplest and most logical and reasonable way that I've ever thought about that. Yeah, the Lord does it first, and then he tells us to do it. So when we do it, we're doing the same thing as the Lord. We're becoming the body of the Lord. So that thing was really, really interesting for me. I was like, wow, that was one of the most simplest, reasonable, logical, rational. I was like, wow. Like, I don't know if I could have explained it even better than that, but that was great. Yeah. Now, when we get into the word, I really like this part. Well, actually, we're in Pastor Joan's part, but I liked it. Well, it was really thought-provoking was how we cannot discern the path with only our own thoughts, right? And when she kind of got into some of the examples, she did talk like very slightly on like rumors against her, right? Like, you know, it's quite shocking. Like, I know some of the rumors already, but when like she's bringing it up, it's like people start thinking with their own thoughts, even though they're in this history, they start saying terrible things about Pastor Joan when she's the one that's being sent by Sunseem, right? Start to make rumors and people start to get confused, right? We can't discern with our own thoughts. And the way, and the, one of the things I really, one great point that, that Simpson gave in the message was that we are like the masters of ignorance. If there's anything we are greater than God at, and we're like, whoa, we're great at, we're greater at something than God. He's like, it's ignorance. I'm like, because it's so true. If there's anything we're greater than God at, it's ignorance. And it's so crazy when you think about it. Because even if you look at just like the U.S. election, no one, everyone's ignorant. We can only know what the Lord tells us. We can only know what God tells us. But there's no such thing as the absolute, oh, absolute right, absolute. We don't even know until the very end. Even Sunseem's comment during the message about Trump, we don't even know what that means until the very, very end. We need to know the Lord, then we can know the path. So I thought that was a really, really interesting thing. Also, other parts of the message, I loved how that concept of Jesus treating everyone well, because he has no idea who God is going to speak through. The great point about that is this. The reason why that's such an amazing point is because it shows that his number one priority is God more than anyone else, more than his feelings, more than who he likes, more than what anyone has done against him. It's always about God. He's looking for God first before his own thoughts, his own premonitions, his own thinking, right? He's thinking about God first, which is quite amazing. I think it's crazy amazing, because for us, we put our thoughts first and then we hate someone and then we don't think about God working through them because we hate them and we don't want to talk to them, right? But the way that he put what Jesus was like is his focus was really prioritized on God first, always looking for God. What is God trying to say before any personal thoughts, biases, perceptions, perspectives, people we hate, people we don't like, all those other things don't even matter to Jesus. And I think that's something like, yeah, man, if we actually started to focus on God more, like God being the absolute focus, imagine how many of these fights and different things that we could avoid more than anything else. And it was just really, just a lot of things were eye-opening yesterday. I also like, of course, this is something that we've heard of many times also. It's that point he brought up when he's like, trees look small from afar, but we don't know until we get close how much of a masterpiece or how amazing it is. It says, in the same way, miracles are ordinary. Jesus looked ordinary. And just these everyday miracles, they are miracles, but you don't know it, and your level's not high enough to see it, right? That we would look at something and say, wow, that is crazy. Because think about this, how many times have we heard Sunseem talk about like, yeah, you guys don't really know the value of warming dome, but when these landscape architecture dudes come in, they're like, what the heck? And they know how impossible it is. We just don't know the value of it because our eyes aren't open to it. And once you raise a level in that area, you get to see that's, oh my goodness, that's crazy kind of thing, right? So I hope that all of us too can raise our level in all the different things. Like even last week, he said, raise a level when it comes to nature. Search for those positive attributes of nature. You got to find it. Once you find it, you'll be able to see how amazing nature is, okay? Oh, what about that spiritual world thing that Sunseem talked about? Wasn't that crazy? Going to the spiritual world and he sees the broad path with many people on it. Then he sees this narrow golden path, just enough to fit your body through. You can't have anything else on it, right? And just the realization from this this spiritual world, this scene that he saw is incredible, actually, if you think about it. Just from seeing this in the spiritual world, how incredible is it? You see how narrow the path is and that there's no one else around. And he realizes, wow, this path is hard to walk. So he quits farming. His dream he throws away because, oh, okay, this is going to be hard, so I can't be doing this. This is the thing that's going to matter more than anything else. Can you imagine, right, having that realization? Enough to throw away all your hopes and dreams and just putting everything aside and doing whatever God wants. That is quite interesting and quite amazing, I think. So, wow. And just the point he made of that path is so narrow, it's only enough for your body. You can't take anything with you. And I think that's something that we need to, that is very, it should stir your heart. You can't take anything, not even your old thoughts, all that baggage of thoughts you have to throw out, right? To take that narrow path, which is a difficult path, right? Probably the last thing, well, yeah. Find, like, pave your own path. That was an interesting thing. Pave your own path to the Lord. And that's something I think I need more time to think about. Like, wow, pave your own path to the Lord. Don't stop in the middle. because if you once you stop, you can't get to the destination. But it was really, really just like, wow, pave your own path to the Lord, right? So that's making a path to the Lord, right? I'm sure it has to do with your individuality. I'm sure it has to do with what is your mission in life, I guess. Yeah, but that's something I really need to think about for this week. I'm hoping it comes out in the Tuesday message or the Wednesday service. Yeah, but last point I want to make is I think we don't understand how what it implies when it's there is only one way. Do you know what I mean? It's an absolute. It's exclusive to the Messiah. It is very exclusive. You cannot get to heaven any other way except through the Messiah. There's no other way. Like, you know, do you know how big that is? Just to think about that, because we can say with our lips, oh, there's only one way. One way, Jesus, you're the only one that I... You know, we sing these songs, but it is an absolute. If there's only one way, we know exactly where to focus. If there's only one way, we know who we should be following with all of our heart. If there's multiple ways, we could just do anything. We could follow anything we want, but there's only one way, and that path is a narrow path too, and we really have to put our lives on the line to do it because there's only one way. There's only one way. Like, I don't know. Like, even in my head, I'm like, whoa, there's only one way? There's only one path to eternal life, and there's no other way, which means that we have to follow that path with everything that we have. Because we're not getting in a wishy-washy way. You just can't. It's impossible. And I think we have to understand how exclusive this is. Like, wow, it's so exclusive. Why is it so exclusive, right? And of course, that's another conversation topic. But I guess the most simplest generic answer would be because of love. That would be the most simplest and generic one, right? Either way. Yeah, I really hope that you guys enjoyed that word study for today, and hope you guys really were able to kind of get your mind stirred a little bit more. Okay, cool. Which means this is going to bring us into the time of the song of choice, the song of the day. And I'm going to choose a song all the way back to 1970. Yes, 70s child is me. Yeah. This is from a group called the Five Stair Steps, and this is a family. It's a family band. Okay, and this song was in the soundtrack for Guardians of the Galaxy, right? And this was the only top 40 hit they had, okay? The only top 40 hit that they have, okay? And they had one more later, I think in 1970s, I think they had one more. But this one was the big one. They're known for this more than anything else. There's been more than 20 covers on this song, okay? The lyrics is called Ooh Child, Things Are Gonna Get Easier. Right, basically means it's telling the listener that things are going to get easier in times of difficulty and strife. So it's a very uplifting message, and it helped it to become a very popular pop R&B song that both pop and R&B audiences loved. Right, and the song, for those of you that want to know, in Rolling Stone magazine, it was ranked number 402 of the 500 greatest songs of all time. Right, I'd love to see that list, who the top 10 were. Either way, this is the Five Stair Steps, and the song is called Ooh Child.
Together and we'll get it undone someday when you hit it much lighter. Someday, yeah, we'll walk in the rays of a beautiful sun. Someday when the world is much brighter.
Ooh, child, things are gonna be easier. Ooh, child, things will be brighter. To be brighter.
Someday, put it together and we'll get it undone.
child, things are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things will get brighter.
And that was the five stair steps. Ooh, child, right? Things are gonna get things. What was that? Ooh, child, things are gonna get easier. Yeah, so it's a good uplifting message. I hope that everyone really enjoyed that. That's from the Five Stair Steps from 1970. Ooh, child. All right, so that brings us into the final segment for today's Monday podcast. And what does that mean? I just want to share something that happened to me last week. Now, you guys know that I had, the pancake people when I talked about my car getting towed. It's really interesting because on Wednesday, Sunsing was saying this was going to be a lot of, like bad things will happen that week, like last week, right? He says, it's gonna be hard this week, you just gotta know bad things are gonna happen. I'm like, okay, I can't get any worse. Why? Because my car got towed and I had to pay, like, in ringgit, it was like 310 ringgit. It's like crazy. And but it's interesting because with this week's message, you know, the last week's message of weaknesses and strengths, the 31 is not Baskin Robbins, but the 31 tribes of Israel, which you had to defeat, right? Which is the 31 maybe weaknesses we might have in ourselves that we have to defeat. So that was on Wednesday, on Tuesday, right? So, no, I think it was on Wednesday, Tuesday or Wednesday. And then Friday comes along. No, Saturday. No, today's, what day is today? Today's Monday. It was on Friday. And Friday, I'm driving, went to the cafe, finished. I went to the grocery store to go shopping. While I'm parking my car, or while I'm driving, I heard this little, I don't know what it was. Then I saw steam coming out of the engine. I'm like, So I go into the parking lot of the grocery store. And then, you know, when you stop and then you want to back into the parking spot, the car just stalls. It's like, it just stalls. I'm like, what? And I'm like, what the heck is going on, right? And I'm like, oh my goodness. And I turned the car back on. It barely got back on. I just pulled it back in and I was like, oh my gosh, it's crazy. I call some people, members are like, hey, I don't know what's going on. Tow truck comes in, takes the car out and take it to a body shop. I went to go pick it up on Saturday night. Gosh, like if it was US dollars, it's like 200 US dollars. Another 200 US dollars, I'm like, what? But here's the interesting thing. This is a thing that was quite interesting. You know, as I'm getting a little bit older, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, one thing that is on my mind a little bit more than usual, like even more in the past, is like financial things, like money and stuff like that. Like, oh my gosh, how am I gonna support myself? How am I gonna live? How am I gonna do this? I'm gonna, you know, all that stuff just raises in your mind. And only because I'm older, right? Because I'm thinking far more ahead now. And when you're younger, you're not thinking so far ahead. You're just thinking like, man, I ate today, I'm fine, right? And you don't really think about tomorrow. Well, you might think as much as tomorrow, the day after, but you know, it's like, you don't think very much in the future. But now I'm a lot older. I'm thinking to myself, oh, how am I going to live in the future? I'm thinking about money. I'm thinking about this and that. And that Wednesday message was really powerful for me because in the message, it's about even if, you know, people are always looking to get more and more comfortable. They're always looking to get more and more comfortable. I'm like, yeah, you know, it's so true. And then it was like, well, even though people, you know, they're looking to get more and more comfortable, like what good is it if you have no salvation? What's the point? And I was like, oh, that's so true. And then this thought, this inspiration came in my head was, if you could advance the gospel, like the kingdom of God powerfully, but die poor, would you do it? Interesting thing was, I thought about it and then I said, you know what? I think I could. Yeah, I could. But the thing that was kind of like, you know what? When I was younger, I would just say, yeah, of course. Amen. Hallelujah, man. Doesn't matter. Do it for the kingdom of God, right? And that would be everything. But, you know, I was thinking to myself is, wow, what good is all these things or trying to live in comfort if it sacrifices what I can do for this history, right? Like, say for instance, I get a full-time job. That doesn't really make any sense. Like, if I'm someone who's supposed to, if I'm someone who runs full-time lecturing, doing all these different things, making these podcasts, whatever, then it'd be like, yeah, like, what would be the point? And I really thought to myself, you know what? I can't be putting, like, I'm not saying don't think about money, because you need to think about money, guys, right? But it's all about priority. Like, even when Jesus talks about it, you either have one, you have one master. It's either money or God. Once you have one as your master, the other one serves the other, right? And of course, that doesn't mean that you can't think about money. It just means that it can't be your master. It can't be the number one thing, because that's what the master is. The master is the top dog, right? So is it either God or is it the money? And I thought to myself, you know what? I got to be the one that trusts. Like, I really do. Like, God will provide. As long as I, you know, put my all into his work, helping out, you know, helping and lecturing, training and doing all the things that I really need to do for this history, I just got to do it. And it was quite interesting because I had this realization after the Wednesday message, and Thursday I was thinking about it, and then Friday is when my car broke down, right? And in my head I was like, huh. And then, of course, in my head, sometimes like, oh, it's going to cost a lot. And, you know, it's like $200. It's like, what? It's like 800-900 ringgit, right? But I was just like, oh my gosh. But honestly, at that point, I was comfortable. I really was. And I think it was one of these, as Sunseem was saying, this is going to be a hard week for many people. A lot of bad things are going to happen. I really thought to myself, oh, and that is a way to look or strengthen or understand our weaknesses better. And it was a very difficult week because, you know, I spent like, you know, like just a ton of money just on getting my car towed and my car not working, right? But it was really interesting because from both of those things, I was able to have realization and also understanding myself, my weaknesses too, and what I need to change in my mindset. That in the past, if money was like such a big thing, you know, I'd be freaking out like, oh, what do I do? What do I do, right? So I thought it was a very, very good week, a very, what you call a very practical week where I can put into action, because you can't see your weaknesses until those big things pop up, right? Or it's not real. Like, you can't fake those weaknesses to just pop out. Like, it has to be a real situation. So I was really thankful to God, really, really thankful to God for last week. I'm hoping you guys have some testimonies too. You guys will have some great stories to talk about. But yeah, I just last week was a really, really good week for me, and now this week I'm really gonna work on having that deep time of prayer more than anything else. But I hope you guys had an amazing week last week, looking at your strengths and weaknesses, but especially this week, as it's going to be a time for us to really look at, you know, understanding what it means that the path, there's only one way, there's one path to the Lord. We have to know the Lord well, discern well, not with our own thoughts, throw them away, but do exactly what the Lord wants. Okay, so everyone have a wonderful and exciting week. It is Monday. It's just the beginning, and I hope that we can start from today. Everyone have a wonderful night. Thank you for joining us here, and we'll see you tomorrow on the Morning Star Drive on 117.8.
It's the Morning Star Drive 117.8. You're soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly, so let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm